We've got a title up for grabs here in Lexington for the number one team in the nation, the South Carolina Gamecocks. Come to Lexington to take on Kentucky. South Carolina is undefeated in SEC play. With a win today, they would clinch at least a share of the SEC title. Kentucky, meanwhile, is trying to stay in the top four in the SEC so they can get a double bye in the SEC tournament. Courtney Lyle and national championship winning head coach Carolyn Peck with you. This is a big game for both of these teams because everybody's looking towards the postseason right now.
Well, it's not just for South Carolina to finish number one and Kentucky to get a top four seed, but we've got two star players that are trying to duke it out for the potential of winning the SEC Player of the Year.
Ryan Howard for Kentucky and Ty Harris for South Carolina. These two players are capable of taking over a game and controlling it for their team.
Well, both of these players are responsible for where their teams are. Ty Harris really directing traffic and dialing up, especially three freshmen in their starting lineup. And Matthew Mitchell said, listen, when you have Ryan Howard on your team, she puts you in the position to potentially beat anybody.
And that's talking about a Ryan Howard who has a broken left hand. She's still putting up the numbers that we're used to seeing from her. Both of these players making a huge case for SEC Player of the Year. Their numbers impressive. Ryan Howard is actually third in the nation in points per game. She can light it up.
Well, and both of these players have major impacts. One is scoring baskets, the other one is distributing the basketball and dialing up the offense from individual players. But both of these players are so much fun to watch.
This is the second meeting between South Carolina and Kentucky. The Gamecocks flat out dominated the Wildcats in the first meeting to open up SEC play, and I guarantee you Kentucky hasn't forgotten that.
Oh, when they came back from South Carolina, it was a toughness practice for two straight days. It paid off again for them against Tennessee. We'll see if they maintain that toughness today.
Aaliyah Boston and Ryan Howard to jump it off. South Carolina controls it. That's Ty Harris, number 52 in the maroon jersey.
Don Staley said one thing they're going to try to continue to do is get points in the paint, attack that blue area, but a turnover by Kiki Herbert-Harrigan.
Kentucky will turn you over multiple times in a game. Ryan Howard is wearing number 10 in the white jersey. Keep an eye on her. Ogechi Anya Galibo making her fifth straight start, excuse me. And there's a big three from Kiki McKinney. Ty Harris leads this group, the number one freshman class in the nation. Aaliyah Boston is a part of that. She scores.
And just every time I watch her, I cannot believe number four for South Carolina is a freshman. Strong, patient, and a great finish inside.
Kentucky has got to be keeping an eye on what happens in the paint when South Carolina is on offense. Unbelievably, Carolina had 60 points in the paint in the first meeting.
And it was a combination of both the post players and the guards driving and South Carolina getting on the offensive glass.
Rebeal picks up her first foul, and Ryan Howard will go to the line. Howard, a 79% free throw shooter. A title is on the line here in Lexington, Kentucky for the number one team in the nation. The South Carolina Gamecocks have not lost a game in SEC play. They've only lost one game all season. Courtney Lyle and national championship winning head coach Carolyn Peck with you. A rematch from earlier in SEC play when South Carolina just dominated Kentucky.
Kentucky is a completely different team from that opener in the SEC, and a lot of that has to do with the toughness and physicality that they had to get ready for in SEC play.
Kiki Herbert-Harrigan knocks down one from the short corner. A win for South Carolina, and they get a portion of the SEC title.
I don't think it's going to be something that's just going to happen today. They're going to have to earn it because Kentucky came out, practiced this morning, and even in the warm-ups, had that determined look, same look they had when they were able to pull off the defeat against Mississippi State. Ryan Howard, man, she's special.
Both of these teams have players that can take over a game. South Carolina, for them, it's number 52. She's got the ball right now. That's Ty Harris. And for Kentucky, it's Ryan Howard. Howard gets the rebound. Jada Roper pushing it and pulls up at the SEC logo.
You can tell Kentucky's got revenge on their mind. Matthew Mitchell said in that first game, in the first meeting, they were dominated. And when you do, when that happens, you could lose your confidence or you go back to the fundamentals. And that's what he has worked on this week.
Kentucky has not forgotten. They gave up 99 points to the Gamecocks in the first meeting. And this is a big game for Kentucky, too, because the Wildcats are trying to stay in the top four of the SEC so they get that double bye in the SEC tournament. As we mentioned, South Carolina, a win today. They clinch a portion of the SEC regular season title.
And you've got Ryan Howard and Ty Harris, two players that really contribute in major ways to their teams in different ways. Ryan Howard, she's a scorer. She's a, when the clock's running down, she's the one that's going to get you buckets. Ty Harris for South Carolina, she's going to distribute and dial up the players that need to make plays at the right place at the right time.
Both of those players in the running for SEC Player of the Year. Ryan Howard was the SEC Freshman of the Year last season. Jada Roper gets blocked by Bree Beal. Beal's going to take it all the way in, gets the foul and the bucket.
Every coach I talk to, all the hype with South Carolina, they talk about Ty Harris, they talk about Aaliyah Boston, but coaches recognize the benefit of having Bree Beal, her size, her strength, her tenacity that she brings to the Gamecocks.
Best known for her defense. That's what earned her a spot in the starting lineup when she got to South Carolina. That's impressive to open up day one and they have three freshmen in the starting lineup.
Just about anybody that South Carolina plays, she's going to draw the assignment of the best player on the opponent's team.
Three-point play for Bree Beal. Don Staley loves that defense that she gets out of her freshman. Sabrina Haynes did pick up her second foul, so she's on the bench for Kentucky right now. That's a big scoring threat.
Yeah, she opens up things, especially from the three-point line for Kentucky.
Chastity Patterson trying to drive in on Beal. They kick back to Howard for three, in and out. Rebound by Patterson. Look, when you need a bucket, you toss it into Aaliyah Boston.
You saw Ty Harris when she came down the floor. Her eyes were to the rim. That was her first option, was to go inside to Boston down low. Beal is all over Ryan Howard.
Amanda Pascal for two. Big bucket. Howard was double teamed down low. Look, Ryan Howard is fantastic, but she's got to have some help today.
Well, around the perimeter, in the first meeting, a lot of times Howard was trapped and there wasn't an out pass or someone ready to make those baskets. But right now, Kentucky's ready for it.
Shot blocked by Beal, but then Beal called for the foul, and that's going to be the second on Bree Beal.
What South Carolina wants to do is force Ryan Howard to go left because of that injury to that left hand. But that hadn't slowed Howard down. She's still staying aggressive, whether it's to the right or the left.
Dawn Staley, also a big day for her. A win would be her 300th win at South Carolina. She would be more concerned about clinching a share of the SEC title than her record, but
I think that Dawn Staley's not even looking at that. It's just, she wants to win every game and keep this team consistent with how they've played all season long.
And it's been impressive, the amount of youth this team has and how it's been tested, and they have come through. South Carolina has beaten 9 ranked teams, more than any other team in the nation. Zaya Cook, explosive.
Each time you watch South Carolina, starting early on, you just wonder when these young freshmen are going to hit that freshman wall. I haven't seen it yet. And we're in late February.
Lily Grissett swipes it from Ryan Howard, but can't finish. Howard in traffic. She'll go back to the free throw line. Man, it's close. Number one team in the nation trailing by a point here in Lexington. You're watching the SEC on ESPN. South Carolina down by 1, but the Gamecocks have benefited from having the luxury of a veteran point guard who knows exactly what Dawn Staley wants.
Now that I'm a senior, I feel like I have more confidence to be an extension of Coach Staley on the court just because I have the confidence to just lead the team. I know what she wants. I have the sound look and feel that she always describes. And I can just be the silent, well, not even the silent leader, the loud leader that she wants me to be, to lead this team and continue to push on.
Hey, nobody better to learn from than the 2-time National Player of the Year, one of the best point guards ever, than Dawn Staley. Her senior season numbers, hey, Ty Harris is right there.
Well, and Ty's been able to learn. She's had the keys to the bus since her freshman year. She's been the starting point guard here. So if anybody knows what Dawn Staley wants at that point guard spot, it's Ty Harris.
I mean, that is so invaluable to have all these freshmen who are being asked to play a big role for South Carolina, to have somebody like Ty Harris on the floor to help them, to guide them, and they all kind of get very calm when she's on the floor.
They trust her.
Yeah.
They really do trust because they know she's going to make the right decisions. She leads by example. She doesn't ask them to do anything she's not willing to do herself.
Zaya Cook. And hey, that's the future right there.
I was going to say, she's the next one to hold the keys.
Patterson throws it into traffic, and South Carolina comes out with it. A couple of turnovers now for the Cats.
That'll be interesting. Can Lily Grissett have the same effect on Ryan Howard that Bree Beal does?
Bree Beal on the bench for South Carolina with 2 fouls. Herbert-Harrigan. And Grissett with the second opportunity.
Can you tell it's the end of February? Everybody's jockeying for position right now.
Well, tomorrow, women's basketball takes over ESPN2 again and the ESPN app at 7 p.m. Eastern. Duke takes on 10th-ranked NC State. And then following that game, Sabrina Ionescu leads number 3 Oregon against number 4 Stanford at Maples Pavilion in a rematch. And Carolyn, you'll be in studio for that.
Duke has won 7 of its last 8. So that'll be an interesting matchup between Duke and NC State. And then Oregon and Stanford. Ionescu needs 9 rebounds. 9 rebounds to be the first player to have 2,000 points, 1,000 rebounds, and 1,000 assists. Those numbers don't even make sense to me.
I know, it's insane. She had 11 rebounds in their first meeting against with Stanford back in January. Hey, that is 4 straight turnovers for Matthew Mitchell's Kentucky Wildcats.
The dead ball turnovers Matthew Mitchell can take against South Carolina. He doesn't want any turnovers, but at least it allows his team to get their defense set.
He's a 2-time SEC Coach of the Year. He has 54 wins over ranked opponents while he's been at Kentucky. This one would be extra sweet.
Well, the one thing that Kentucky has always brought since Matthew Mitchell has come to Lexington is a defensive intensity.
And it's not just in games. He expects that intensity in practice, every moment, in shoot around. It is tough.
You got to have energy. You got to bring energy. And he's got 3 assistants that help him get that out of his team. That's a great cut.
by Lily Grissett. There's a little chatter going on between number 24 and number 10.
Pascal will pull it out. Driving inside on Grissett. Aaliyah Boston crashes the boards. Ty Harris knew exactly where to send it. Zaya Cook running the floor with her. Oh, in and out for Aaliyah Boston. Howard steps back just for two.
Watch Ty Harris. Her vision. She'll survey the situation and then find out. Right person, right time.
Just beautiful. Knew exactly what was going to happen. The defense was going to crash. Lily Grissett got it. That's 8 straight points for South Carolina.
I'll tell you what makes Ty Harris so good is she doesn't pass the ball in a bailout situation. She gets into a situation knowing that when option one is taken away, she's going to have option two or three available.
Ty Harris in the running, definitely for SEC Player of the Year. I don't know if there's anybody who's more valuable to their team in the SEC than Ty Harris is.
I have had conversations because I'm really struggling with this. Ty Harris, for me, with what she has done in leading South Carolina to the number, not just the number one position in the SEC, the number one team in the country. To me, that earns her the right or to be considered for Player of the Year. But you've got Ryan Howard and the numbers she's putting up in the SEC. So it's a matter of Player of the Year or most valuable player. Is there a difference?
Ooh, it's a tough one. You saw those standings. South Carolina 13-0. They have not lost in SEC play. They only have one loss this season, and that was to a ranked Indiana team. A win today for Carolina. They clinch at least a share of the SEC title. Ty Harris knows now, too, when to call her own number.
Absolutely. She's so smart, and her team trusts her decisions. Like, she, at a high rate of speed.
Oh, and they're going to get her on the offensive foul. Coming down, she had given the ball up.
She knew it. Yeah. Amanda Pascal was there. She even tried to help her from falling down. But she knew it.
That's her first. Kentucky's trying to end this run for Carolina. The Gamecocks have scored 10 straight points.
The first quarter has been where South Carolina puts their opponents away. Normally outscoring their opponents by almost 12 points a game in the first quarter.
They average almost 23 points per game in the first quarter, and they shoot 50% from the field in the opening 10 minutes.
Well, when you start a game, you want to get off to a great start. That's exactly what South Carolina does.
They have yet to trail after the first quarter. Oh, a blocking foul called on Tatiana Wyatt as Destiny Henderson drives in. Well, number 11 Louisville is in Tallahassee to take on number 8 Florida State at 7 p.m. in the first half of our Big Monday doubleheader. The Big 12 will follow as number 3 Kansas, who just beat Baylor, hosts Oklahoma State at Allen Fieldhouse, both games on ESPN and the ESPN app.
On the men's side, it's almost a curse to be ranked number 1.
Yeah.
You can't stay there too long.
Not allowed.
Not like South Carolina. They planted themselves there for quite a while.
13 straight points for the Gamecocks. Remember, Kentucky does not have Sabrina Haynes on the floor. She's been in foul trouble. That's one of their scorers. 4 seconds. Not a lot of time. And Tatiana Wyatt traveled. That's 7 turnovers for Kentucky here in the first quarter.
talk about the offensive options for South Carolina. Their defense is pretty daggum good.
And they get an easy bucket from Destiny Henderson. Patterson heaves it up. Not close. Kentucky scoreless in the last 5 minutes. South Carolina up big. South Carolina scores 15 straight to end the first quarter. They lead Kentucky 27-14 back here inside Memorial Coliseum. And at first we saw a little bit of fight out of this Kentucky team, but South Carolina is so experienced. Even when times get tough, they seem pretty calm.
Well, you get high percentage shots when you go in the paint, and South Carolina already has 18 paint points. 18. They had 60 the first time these two teams met.
Yeah, these two teams haven't forgotten that first meeting. It was pretty intense to open up SEC play. South Carolina put up 99 points on this Kentucky team. And it was a tough game for both teams. That's Ryan Howard's injury. What we're talking about was the last time that these two teams played, and it was back to open up SEC play. Yeah, those 60 points in the paint were just so impressive for South Carolina, and Kentucky was rattled right off the bat with a lot of turnovers.
When you look at the size of South Carolina, you think, well, they got paint points because they're going inside to Aaliyah Boston. But it's not just their post play. The guards attack off the bounce, getting paint points as well.
Kentucky didn't score for over 5 minutes to end that first quarter.
Watch Aaliyah Boston, the freshman center, directing traffic of who needs to be where.
Victoria Saxton. Second chance and a fresh 20 for South Carolina. They only need 3 seconds of it.
Well, you've got Lily Grissette. She has really stayed hungry to get offensive boards, even though moving from the four in the post position out to the three.
Kentucky is usually so good when it comes to turning opponents over, and tonight they're the one that's being turned over. They have 7 turnovers to South Carolina's 2.
What I like about South Carolina's passing of the basketball is they pass it away from the defense. It's not the bailout pass, but a pass with a purpose.
Pascal steps back and hits. She's hit a couple of shots from that spot.
She's been big as of late for Kentucky, really contributing in that scoring, and they need her today, especially with Sabrina Haynes being in foul trouble.
Haynes picked up 2 fouls early in the first quarter. Zaya Cook elevates and is going to the line. Well, tomorrow women's basketball takes over ESPN2 and the ESPN app at 7 p.m. Eastern. Duke will face the 10th-ranked NC State. And then up next, Sabrina Ionescu leads number 3 Oregon against number 4 Stanford at Maples Pavilion. Everybody's keeping an eye on Sabrina. Of course, one of the players being talked about for National Player of the Year, obviously. She just had her 25th career triple-double on Friday.
She's putting up ridiculous numbers, and it's... You said, well, she can't do this or that. I don't know if there's anything that she can't do. She sees the floor so well. Kelly Graves has moved her around in different positions throughout the season. And then at that point guard spot, her decision making is fantastic.
Kentucky is getting in a hole right now. South Carolina is on a 19-2 run.
You know, I'm shocked. And this is what I'm shocked about, because teams that are very focused in big games and come out, and the warm-up is so intense. But South Carolina came out like another day at the office. When the game starts, the lights come on, they turn it up.
Howard misses on the second opportunity. Third chance goes through. 9 points for Ryan Howard.
She just needs some help.
How much do you think South Carolina's composure has to do with their scheduled testing?
Well, that's one of the things that Dawn Staley said. In the non-conference, they were tested. They started out early against a team like Maryland, who was ranked, 5th in the country? And then she said, once you get into SEC play,
teams know you, and so they will throw all kinds of junk. So they've been prepared to be in this situation.
They are 9-1 against ranked opponents this season. That leads the nation.
The composure of a young team. You only have two seniors, and they don't get rattled.
McKinney will pop the three. Hey, she can hit it from out there. That's her second today.
That's one player that brings swagger for Kentucky to help out Ryan Howard.
Pascal with the extra hustle to get in there and get that rebound. It back to Anya Galibo. Shakes off Victoria Saxton and gets to Anya Galibo with a chance at a three-point play.
Ryan Howard reads the help coming off the ball screen.
You got it. Anya Galibo.
Anya Galibo does a smart thing. Thank you. Of using the shot fake because she knows South Carolina's shot blocking team. They're gonna leave their feet.
They needed some extra energy and toughness in the starting lineup. They put Ogechi Anya Galibo in there the last five games. Herbert-Harrigan. Short. Oh, and Grissett tipped it out to Henderson. Henderson got tangled up. Ryan Howard's got it.
It was just tough for Howard to handle with that splint on that left hand. Like she just says, I just couldn't pick it up. Didn't have full use of that left hand.
She broke the little finger on her left hand, which is her non-shooting hand, back on January 27th, missed three games. But her numbers have not dropped off since she's come back.
Not at all. Even in the Mississippi State game, you could tell that Vic Schaefer wanted his team to send her left. It didn't slow her down.
Yeah, you see her numbers before the injured hand and then after, almost 24 points per game before. She's still at almost 23 points per game now.
You put a bandage on the left hand, but that doesn't take away the heart that Ryan Howard plays with.
Jada Roper will pull it out and give it to Howard, who steps into the three.
The pressure that Ty Harris keeps on the defense, staying aggressive offensively.
Look, and you don't see her turn to the bench. She calls the plays most of the time for South Carolina. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Jada Roper goes down hard. Roper to a streaking Anya Galibo right to the rack. 9 straight for Kentucky. South Carolina only has 4 points in the second quarter.
Needs to find Ryan Howard.
Howard signaled to Jada Roper to pull it back, set something up. Tough shot. Herbert-Harrigan got a piece of it. That's the third foul on Sabrina Haynes. Hey, Kentucky's on a run right now. Watch out, South Carolina. Guys, thank you. This Kentucky team, dangerous right now for South Carolina. We want to remind you, this is a Play for K game. You can support the KU Cancer Fund in partnership with the WBCA and the V Foundation for Cancer Research. Donate at KU.com. Funds raised will go to Women's Cancer Research. Well, Matthew Mitchell is wearing a mic for us today. He has been animated over on the Kentucky sideline.
We had some focus to start the game, and now we've lost control of our emotions. We're not focused on our fundamentals, and now you're just going to just lay down and let them lay the ball up. Get your mind on what you're supposed to be doing. Get in a stance. Fundamentals.
I think that worked because Kentucky was showing some life here. They had 9 straight points until those free throws from Ty Harris.
Because it's just not what you do physically in a ball game. Mentally, you've got to be locked in as well. And like Coach Mitchell said, keep control of your emotions. South Carolina's going to make their runs, but how do you respond or handle those runs will determine whether you stay in this ball game or not.
Look at Boston working on Anya Galibo.
That was a monster post move. Big, huge ducky, and what I love about her is she doesn't predetermine her moves. She catches it and knows where the defense is and then takes advantage of that. Look at this big ducky and then spinning back to the left. You get yourself to the free throw line. You might not get the bucket, but you can get them right here at the free throw line.
You know, we asked her about not shying away from physicality in the post, and she goes, yeah, I love all that funness down there.
How many freshman post players come into their freshman year in college and call physical play funness?
She's the only one I know of so far.
I'm keeping that in my notebook for all 4 years of her career at South Carolina. Funness.
Funness. And hey, she made Ogechi Anyagalibo pick up her second foul. So she's on the bench. There's a big three from Ryan Howard. Howard's up to 12.
Coach Landers made a good point for this game not to be a blowout, and Ryan Howard was only 2 for 9 before that bucket.
A whistle away from the ball, and it's on Tatiana Wyatt.
You know, when Ryan Howard decides to turn things up, that was even with a hand in her face, she was able to knock that shot down.
That's 2 fouls on Tatiana Wyatt, so Kentucky is going to have to send in Nene Cole. She's only made 12 appearances this season. This is her 13th appearance for South Carolina. But they're in foul trouble right now.
That's a tough part about guarding South Carolina when you just have a limited number of post players to go to, because it takes more than one person to guard Aaliyah Boston, and more times than not, you find yourself getting into that foul trouble situation.
Kenny's hit 2 threes already. She'll give it up to Roper. Howard comes around and gets it. Looking for her 3rd three, in and out for Kiki McKinney. Herbert-Harrigan off the glass.
The unselfish play, the willingness to find the better shots from South Carolina's players, so impressive.
You can see how well they know each other by the way they move the ball and share the ball on the floor.
I said it earlier, trust. It starts with Ty Harris, the point guard, but it flows throughout this whole South Carolina team.
Nene Cole is fouled.
When you're unselfish and your number one priority is to go win ball games, then you're willing to share the basketball. When you can find an opportunity for your teammate to get a layup, that's the highest percentage shot you can get on the floor.
Herbert-Harrigan did just pick up her 2nd foul. Nene Cole is 6 of 8. Now 7 of 9 from the free throw line this season.
But even though Kiki Herbert-Harrigan may have picked up her other 2nd foul, the depth of the bench for South Carolina. You know, now she can go to Victoria Saxon. South Carolina is getting 26 points a game.
from their bench players.
It's 32% of their offense is coming from the bench.
That's it. I mean, that's tough because they can continually bring fresh players at you, and they're not going to take a step down when they go to players coming in that second squad.
I mean, could you almost feel the second team on South Carolina's bench?
It's an extension of the first team.
Yeah. It went off of Kentucky.
You had Lili Brissett that had to come in for Bree Bill in foul trouble. That's another big guard that's got an aggressive rebounding mentality. Tough defense. A great cut by Lili Brissett.
Leads back up to 8 for Carolina. They've led by as many as 15.
You see Brissett's trying to play on Ryan Howard's right shoulder.
Seconds. I think they had Howard on the trip. Yes. That's just the first on her.
Matthew Mitchell, I believe, felt like the two players' feet just got tangled up. It wasn't an intentional trip, and the official, though, had to call something and called the foul.
This is a big game for both teams. A win for South Carolina clinches a portion of the SEC title. Kentucky is trying to strengthen their case for a top 4 seed in the SEC tournament, meaning they would get a double bye.
You got two players making a case for who should be SEC Player of the Year.
3 seconds. Pascal puts up the shot. It's short. Shot clock violation on Kentucky. Matthew Mitchell has gotten some fight to come back in this Kentucky Wildcat team.
Well, he really had to talk about get to your fundamentals. That's the way Kentucky's going to get themselves back into this game.
Ten-point lead for South Carolina. They've led by as many as 15 today, but Kentucky has pushed the Gamecocks here in the second quarter. 17.8 seconds until the half. South Carolina can take the last shot. Nene Cole is all over Aaliyah Boston. The shot will come from Harris, and it's off the mark. South Carolina trying to get closer and closer to a share of the SEC regular season title. They can do it with a win today. Welcome back to the 2020 Play for K, honoring the KOW Cancer Fund in partnership with the WBCA and the V Foundation. South Carolina with a 10-point lead at the half. A win today would give them a share of the SEC regular season title. Back inside Memorial Coliseum, Courtney Lyle and Carolyn Peck with you. We've been watching the battle in the paint because remember in the first meeting, South Carolina had 60 paint points against Kentucky.
And they're well on their way, headed towards 60 in this game in the first half. 24 points in the paint. Kiki Herbert-Harrigan, the guards got involved attacking the basket. And even with the defense in rotation, they've been able to find each other to get the easy two inside.
South Carolina led by as many as 15 in that first half. They've got 24 points in the paint, but Kentucky was able to put together a run. Matthew Mitchell got really fired up over on the bench, and he's wearing a mic for us today.
And now we've been much more aggressive and made some big shots. That's a great job there, guys. Way to weather the storm. Here we go! Come on! But right now, here's what I want you to focus on. Being aggressive on offense, going to the basket. Getchy!
Hey, we were talking at the half. We feel like this Kentucky team has got another run in them.
I think so. And one of the things that Matthew Mitchell had talked about in practice yesterday was that he felt like his team could drive against South Carolina. They had success with that in their first meeting. So I would look for him to go to more of that in the second half.
Ryan Howard just picked up her second foul. Bree Beal at the line. Beal spent the majority of the first half on the bench due to foul trouble, and she's South Carolina's best defender.
Well, there may be a contest for that because Lily Grissett did one heck of a job in off the bench.
She gave them a great effort. Grissett had 10 points in the first half, 3 rebounds.
She was aggressive defensively. She and Ryan Howard, they stayed very close to each other in that first half.
Tips of Beal. Kentucky will take it. That's the 6th turnover for South Carolina. Oh, what a pass from Ryan Howard to Anya Galibo. And she draws the foul by Leah Boston. Her first.
You got to understand how much attention is going to go to Ryan Howard. So if you're the screener and the roller, you got to look for the basketball because your defender is going to give a second look to Ryan Howard as long as she's got the ball.
Nicolibo 0-for-2 from the free throw line today. Now, she hasn't missed from the field. She's 2-for-2.
I love talking to her. She is one of the most intelligent basketball players and people you will ever meet. Everything is well thought out. Everything has a plan and a place.
She's a pre-med major, started her career at Stony Brook and was the American East Rookie of the Year, and then had to sit out 2 seasons due to transferring and then an injury before she could actually play at Kentucky.
And now being rewarded, moved into the starting lineup because of her high basketball IQ and the energy that she brings.
And South Carolina's trying to make some tough passes down low right now.
Trying to force it. They've got to get back to not allowing the basketball to get stuck, moving it freely.
You get it into Herbert-Harrigan. She loves that spot on the floor. It's almost automatic. 7 points now for Kiki.
Don Staley talked about when you get into the SEC season, you're playing opponents that know you so well. Because you're running a lot of stuff that you've run throughout your whole time out of school. So they're going back to the file, and they know each other. Now there's a difference in knowing it and stopping it, and how you're sharp against opponents that know you.
First foul on Zaya Cook. Kentucky in trouble. They throw it up, and Howard's there. Anya Galibo trying to get past Aaliyah Boston. First field goal she's missed today.
Boston knew she needed to get out of the lane.
Getchy, Anya Galibo called for her 3rd. Kentucky had a little bit of foul trouble down low in that first half. Tatiana Wyatt is going to replace Anya Galibo. And keep in mind, Wyatt also has 2 fouls already.
It's just a tall task of going against the physical play of the post players inside of South Carolina.
This is definitely, though, a different performance we're seeing from Kentucky than we did in that first meeting with South Carolina. I mean, they gave up 99 points to the Gamecocks.
Well, they had no choice because we watched those two practices following that first meeting. And the number one thing that Matthew Mitchell wanted from his team is that they had to compete and they had to understand the physicality that this team was going to face in the SEC season.
Tatiana Wyatt gets it from Ryan Howard. Offensive foul on Aaliyah Boston, her second personal.
Some of that funness going on inside.
Too much funness. Remember, South Carolina, they're 13-0 in SEC play, win today. And they would get a share of the SEC regular season title. It would be their fifth SEC regular season title.
There's a three-way tie right now for that third and fourth spot for Kentucky. A win for the Wildcats today would help to make their case to end up in the top four and get that double bye the first round in the SEC tournament just in a week or so.
That's hard to believe. It's almost here. Zaya Cook, beautiful shot. She's up to nine.
I like her bounce.
Oh, nobody had Jada Roper there for a minute.
Well, but the defensive, they covered for each other. Kiki Herbert-Harrigan helped out Aaliyah Boston, who had helped out Zaya Cook.
South Carolina's got a call timeout as Herbert-Harrigan drops to the ground. Zaya Cook's got 9 points for Carolina.
You got a young freshman that's got skills like this. It'll help you as a head coach to sleep well at night. Number one, just makes plays.
Welcome back to the SEC on ESPN. Well, it's been a big week around women's basketball. Dawn Staley was named a finalist for the 2020 Naismith Coach of the Year Award. She would be the only player to win the Naismith Player of the Year and Coach of the Year Award. How cool would that be?
Be fantastic. It's just remarkable what she's done at South Carolina. But talk about remarkable, Kim Mulkey, fastest coach, male or female, to get to 700 wins. Trivia, Courtney?
Yes.
Who did she overtake for that fastest to 700 wins?
Well, this is very fitting because we're in Lexington. Adolph Rupp.
Nice. There you go, partner.
He did it in 704 games, I believe.
And then you've got Sabrina Ionescu has her 25th triple-double. Holy cow, and she's only 9 rebounds away from having 2,000 points, 1,000 assists, and 1,000 rebounds.
Don't forget, you can see her try to hit that mark. She would be the only player to hit that tomorrow night at 9 Eastern on ESPN2. Peck will be in studio. She's got you covered.
Let's go up there and visit with Andy Landers and John Brickley.
Hey, those are the first points right there for Ryan Howard in the second half.
I'm going to tell you, when it becomes Howard time, this could be real interesting and get the Wildcats right back in this ball game. She can turn it up.
Third in the nation in points per game is Ryan Howard. Stay with South Carolina. Kentucky fans wanted an offensive foul on Bree Beal.
Beal playing with 3 fouls.
Aaliyah Boston is on the bench for South Carolina. She's got 3 fouls. Cook loses it and tries to get it back. Nobody can hang on to the ball right now. Shot clock violation on South Carolina.
Handshake between Jada Roper, Ryan Howard. It's plays like that that can swing the momentum in your team's favor.
Does it help they're wearing the same SpongeBob shoes also? The connection is real, guys. The connection is real.
Call it up, Lyle. Call it up.
Maybe you just need a secret handshake every once in a while. It's the second bucket for Jada Roper.
I tell you, you just needed just a little taste and can turn things up for the Wildcats.
Herbert-Harrigan is fouled by McKinney.
Jada Roper trying to help Ryan Howard out. How do you do it? Little teardrop could be just exactly what Kentucky needs.
The power of one.
Every minute,
a woman is diagnosed with cancer.
One mother.
One daughter.
One wife.
The KL Cancer Fund is working to stop the clock. $1.
One drug.
One life.
We'll support the KL Cancer Fund in partnership with the WBCA and the V Foundation for Cancer Research. You can donate at kyow.com. Funds raised will go to women's cancer research. And since this started in 2007, they have raised $7.78 million to fight all cancers affecting women. It's just remarkable how KEL's fight continues.
Well, it's amazing what the research can do. Back in the early 90s, my mother was diagnosed with colon cancer, stage 4, and it was a experimental drug that she was able to take and be a part of, and my mother is still here to this day because of research that is done to try to find a cure for this horrible disease.
Again, you can donate at kyow.com. Kentucky has really tested South Carolina. They are pushing the Gamecocks right now after trailing by 15 in the first half. Oh, and Jada Roper is fouled, shooting the long ball. Second foul on Ty Harris.
South Carolina had gone to a box and one, really paying attention to Ryan Howard, daring someone else for Kentucky to beat them. And I'm going to tell you, this is a Kentucky team that any player can get hot from the perimeter.
Well, tonight at 9 p.m. on ESPN and the ESPN app, D. Wade, Life Unexpected. ESPN Films chronicles Dwayne Wade's experiences on and off the court. An unprecedented look at his life with never-before-seen footage from his childhood days in Chicago to Marquette, Miami, and everything in between. Tonight at 9 on ESPN.
That's going to be interesting. I can't wait to watch that. He is such a unique person.
Definitely appointment television. Jada Roper gets all three. They've cut it to 9.
Now Kentucky trying to get a stop, keeping South Carolina on the perimeter.
Victoria Saxton swarmed by the defense. They're going to double check. Did she get the shot off in time? The shot clock was winding down. Bev Roberts will go to the monitor. Remember, they don't have Aaliyah Boston on the floor. She's got 3 fouls, so Victoria Saxton is another option they have.
You watch. When does the clock go to 0 and the red lights come on?
I don't think she got it off in time.
Watch the clock.
I think it was still in her hand.
Yeah, it's close. She was in the act of shooting, but I don't know if her fingertips had come off the ball before the clock went to zero. If that's a stop, this is a big momentum builder for Kentucky.
If they wave that bucket off, South Carolina hasn't had a field goal in almost 3 minutes.
It's been tough to get buckets without Aaliyah Boston on the floor.
Yeah, shot clock violation on South Carolina. It was still in her hand. Aaliyah Boston went to the bench at the 6:22 mark, and since then, Kentucky has outscored South Carolina 7-2.
Now defensively, South Carolina is in a box and one. Destiny Henderson is going to be the chaser on Ryan Howard. But you've got Sabrina Haynes in the game, who can shoot the ball for Kentucky, and Kiki McKinney's already hit a three today.
Haynes doesn't have any points. Remember, she was in foul trouble most of the first half. Wyatt comes and gets it at the elbow. Herbert-Harrigan swats it away.
So with this zone, Destiny Henderson gives up size to Ryan Howard. Ryan Howard can come through and post up.
Howard pops the quick three. It'll be South Carolina ball.
See now, offensively for South Carolina, Zaya Cook and Kiki Herbert-Harrigan have got to be the go-to.
There's Zaya Cook, number one in the Garnet jersey. She makes that look so easy. It's not, but she sure makes it look easy.
But when you have a player on your team like Zaya Cook, you just call her number. She's going to make something happen.
11 points for Cook. And Matthew Mitchell calls timeout. South Carolina back up to an 11-point lead.
Well, after Kiki Herbert-Harrigan had cut through the lane, then Zaya Cook going against a post player. And with her quickness at any point, right when she has you on your heels, is when she's going to elevate and make shots.
Zaya Cook, part of this number one recruiting class for Dawn Staley. She was number four in last year's class. That has helped South Carolina put together a pretty solid resume for the NCAA tournament. Their RPI is 2. They're projected as the number one overall seed. And oh, by the way, they've beaten 9 ranked opponents.
That's impressive. And the one loss that they had was against Indiana down in the Virgin Islands. And that's when Aaliyah Boston was dealing with one of her teachers from her prep school had passed away, and so emotionally had to adjust to that. But since then, South Carolina has taken off, and they have not looked back.
20 straight, 13-0 in SEC play. A win today, they get a share of the SEC title.
It's very rare that you see South Carolina throwing out a junk defense, but the box and one has really caused some problems for Ryan Howard.
Zaya Cook working again, and this time is going to the line.
The versatility of South Carolina's ability to score. And normally when you have Aaliyah Boston on the floor, you always have the option to go inside without her. Now what does South Carolina do? They can go to a Zaya Cook. They can go to a Kiki Herbert-Harrigan. You've also got Destiny Henderson, who's a tremendous shooter and can also run the point as well and free up Ty Harris.
A 12-point lead for Carolina. Their largest lead today has been 15 in the second quarter.
South Carolina going back to a man-to-man.
Henderson is on Howard. Howard sees a lane and gets fouled going up. Howard only has 2 points in the second half.
So running an offense that switches a post on Howard. Howard has the advantage there because she's got the quickness to go off the bounce and attack Victoria Saxon.
Howard's 5 of 6 from the line. You can bump that up.
Four of 14 from the floor. Ryan Howard's most successful area to score has been from that free throw line area. She's not getting any easy looks. She's had to attack through everything she's tried to do offensively.
Harris with the pull up. Seconds on the shot clock for Kentucky.
The defense of South Carolina. They keep you covered.
Roper trying to go high over Victoria Saxton. Cook can just take just enough off of it.
And she had an option with Henderson to the wing. That's a good decision by the freshman. Take it.
5 of 8 from the field. Stolen away by Cook. She wants some more. And she'll get it.
She was about to give you the flex. You know, when Zaya Cook puts that flex on you, it's over.
16 points for Zaya Cook.
She hadn't brought it yet. The flex hadn't come just yet. She was about to.
You just wait, Peck.
It's coming.
Hard into Victoria Saxton. And they're going to call her for the foul. Third on Saxton. And look at the stats right now. Kentucky doesn't have a rebound in the third quarter.
But you look at the boxing out and the defense of South Carolina, they're not allowing any second chance opportunities from Kentucky. Don Staley didn't like that call.
One shot.
But I like her boots. They've got a picture of Coach Yao painted on them. Those are Kay Yao boots. The shoe chef out of Lexington, South Carolina, Doug Rumorheads, made those specifically for Coach Don Staley.
They look good to play good.
Right?
Look good to coach good. South Carolina's hit its last 4 shots. Henderson spins around Sabrina Haynes. Oh, and they get it back. And just enough time for Ty Harris to draw the foul and go to the line.
That'll be 3 on Ryan Howard. The heads-up play by Ty Harris, not giving up on the play and understanding Kentucky is a shot-blocking team. Just a little head fake allows her to get Ryan Howard up in the air.
Thank you.
for her. And the freshman goes 4 for 4 from the field in the third quarter. 10 minutes left here in Lexington.
Good to hear where Kia Jackson's got. Just a little disappeared a little bit in Mississippi State's last game.
Yeah, but she was big down the stretch in that fourth quarter against Auburn and in the overtime game because Maya Taylor had fouled out and so had Jordan Danbury.
Yeah.
So that freshman, Rekia Jackson, had stepped up big.
Mississippi State right now, according to Charlie Cream, is a 3 seed. South Carolina is the number 1 overall seed, according to Charlie Cream. And right now he's got this Kentucky team as a 6 seed. Hey, the good news is Tennessee is still on this list because they won today. If they had lost to Vanderbilt, Charlie Cream said they were out of the tournament.
And I still don't think that Tennessee is out of the woods yet because they still have 2 more games left in the regular season. They're going to have to finish out strong to stay secure in the tournament.
Big 3 from Sabrina Haynes, her first points today. She averages 10 points a game.
She told me yesterday that she knew she was going to have to be an outlet, a relief for the concentration of the defense on Ryan Howard. She's got to make shots.
They need her in this final 10 minutes, that's for sure. Ryan Howard is out there. You see her bringing the ball down the floor. She's got 3 fouls.
The thing I love about Ryan Howard is she can play 1 through 4, even 5 if she needs to.
Saxton blocked her. Cook threw it away. And there's a foul on Lily Grissett. Her second.
Watch Grissett on Ryan Howard.
Got Nate Cole on the roll. Oh, and she just lost it.
That's been open a few times for Kentucky. It's coming off the ball screen. South Carolina's defense pays so much attention to the ball handlers. The post players for Kentucky got to be ready to collect the basketball and finish.
11 turnovers now for Kentucky. South Carolina's got 10. Henderson in trouble. Nope, I lied. She's fine.
I don't know if you can ever say that Kentucky, a South Carolina player, is in trouble. They all have that ability to make something good out of a bad situation.
Kiki McKinney has now hit 3 3-pointers today.
Kentucky is a dangerous team with their ability to get hot from the 3-point line.
That ties her career high. Offensive foul. And it's on Victoria Saxton. Her 4th.
Kentucky's got Ryan Howard, Sabrina Haynes, Kiki McKinney with all the ability, even Amanda Pascal, of knocking down the 3-point shot.
Aaliyah Boston and Ty Harris have come back in for South Carolina. Boston's got 3 fouls. Pascal will run the point for Kentucky. Henderson looking for space, just a little bit short. And it's going to be Kentucky ball as Destiny Henderson is called for the foul. Her 1st.
Well, Henderson compounded a bad situation. She forced a shot, allowed Kentucky to get the rebound, and then reaching in and getting called for the foul.
Thank you.
Bell takes it back. They'll try something else. 10 seconds on the shot clock. That's a foul on Ty Harris. Her third.
So that's four fouls on South Carolina. One more and the rest of the distance in the fourth quarter. Kentucky shoot free throws.
Bucket won't count. They called the foul before. And it's on Amanda Pascal, her third. Everybody's getting foul happy right now.
Yeah, it could be a free throw shooting contest down the stretch.
Henderson with a lane. Too much, Aaliyah Boston. Her put back. A little too much on it. Kentucky with a lot of chances underneath.
Kentucky's got numbers. Lily Grissette late getting down.
Sabrina Haynes under the basket has to pull it out. Too much traffic. Cats have time. Oh, and coming down, Herbert-Harrigan got hit hard.
But this is what happens when you play South Carolina. You know that they're a shot-blocking team. You're better off to use a shot fake than throwing up an off-balance shot.
That was the first foul on Nate Cole. Chastity Patterson comes back in the game for Kentucky. Patterson has only played 6 minutes.
Remember against Arkansas, she caught fire, 32 points.
In the last five games, she's been averaging almost 20 points a game. Great defense from Amanda Pascal. Off of South Carolina.
Kentucky going in against the land of the Giants. The defense is going to collapse. What the offense for Kentucky needs to do is spread the floor. When the defense collapses in, kick out. Shooting the three is a strength of the Wildcats.
Ryan Howard will take a seat for Kentucky. Oh, Lily Grissette so close. South Carolina's going to sneak in Zaya Cook to replace Lily Grissette. She has been working hard against Ryan Howard.
She's had her hands full, and right now Matthew Mitchell has taken Ryan Howard out of the game. Get her a quick blow before the media timeout.
Six seconds on the shot clock. Roper just got stuffed. And it's a shot clock violation on Kentucky. Aaliyah Boston all over it. Matthew Mitchell wanted a foul.
But Aaliyah Boston times it perfectly. I don't think that's a foul. That's a good block.
Six blocks for South Carolina. Second chance for Boston. It rolls out of bounds. It'll be South Carolina ball. Under 5 minutes to go here in Lexington. Gamecocks lead it. Wow, keeping an eye on that Alabama game.
something about those teams from the state of Alabama that are giving Mississippi State a fit. Auburn gave them all they could handle, and right now Alabama has taken the lead.
Well, Kentucky is trying to jump back on South Carolina. Matthew Mitchell's got a mic on for us. Let's check in on the Kentucky sideline.
Guys, just make a run right here. You can listen, I'm telling you right now, you can get this done. You got to make a run right now. But we've got to stop letting them get so deep in the paint guard. So engage your core, level off, make them pick up their dribble.
Peck, engage your core.
I've got mine engaged right now. But right there, Kentucky did not, because Ty Harris got all the way to the basket.
Harris has 10 points, 2 rebounds, 6 assists, and she's going to the line.
Right now, South Carolina's not made a 3. And so what Matthew Mitchell is trying to employ his team to do is keep your person in front of you. Make them shoot jump shots.
Kentucky has missed its last 8 shots. Tisha on me here jumps into Howard.
Kentucky's execution, making the defense have to shift and move so that when you get the ball to Ryan Howard, they're not set and ready, but it's on the move. That makes her even harder to guard.
Ryan Howard is 8 for 10 from the free throw line today. She's got 17 points, right at her average. Well, Sunday Sports Center, 11 p.m. on ESPN and the ESPN app with John Anderson and Michael Eaves. Celtics Lakers reaction, plus sitting down with the man, down with the man himself, Dwayne Wade, and the lasting power of the Miracle on Ice in this week's SC feature.
Kentucky trying to pull off a miracle here in Lexington, Kentucky.
Yeah, South Carolina has not lost to an SEC opponent. They've won 20 in a row. Their only loss was to a ranked Indiana team this season, and a win today would give South Carolina a share of the SEC regular season title. It would be their 5th. Out of bounds off of South Carolina.
Again, Matthew Mitchell said, if you have Ryan Howard on your team, you have a chance to beat just about anyone.
Tried to get it around Boston, got stuck under the basket. 10 seconds left for Kentucky. Roper with the floater. And an offensive board for Kentucky. Matthew Mitchell calls timeout. Under 3 to go, Kentucky has missed its last 10 shots.
Well, Matthew Mitchell wants to make sure that he gets a good shot out of this possession. With under 3 minutes, you don't want to throw up a bad shot or give South Carolina the opportunity to run without getting your defense set. So you want to get a good shot, and I've got to believe he wants this shot to come from Ryan Howard.
And neither team is shooting very well here in the fourth quarter. Kentucky's shooting 15% from the field. South Carolina is shooting 20% from the field.
And I'm sure that Dawn Staley is making sure that her defense is focused on keeping the ball out of the hands, or at least making the defense have Ryan Howard have to take a contested shot.
Well, lots of people watching this. John Calipari, the Kentucky men's basketball head coach, watching. They had a big crowd for their win over Florida yesterday. That was a close one, too.
I was going to say, they had to claw. Wildcats get their their way back over the Gators.
You like that. Hey, but you know who's a big fan of Ryan Howard? Coach Cal.
You know who's Coach Cal's a big fan of Ryan Howard as well.
That's what I just said.
Oh, I thought you said Ryan Howard was a fan of Coach Cal. I'm listening.
It's back and forth. It's a two-way street.
There you go.
How about that? Offensive board, and she's going to the line.
And Coach Cal got on his feet for that play.
Here picks up her second foul. Look, how could you not be a fan of Ryan Howard?
Well, the thing that Coach Cal likes is effort. Players that give effort and play hard, and I think that's the biggest thing he appreciates from Ryan Howard.
Yeah, and it's all aspects of the game. It's not just her offensive game. She wants to rebound well. That's why she's got a double-double right now. Her sixth double-double this season. She's got three assists, two in this game.
Well, Coach Cal talks about the freshmen. You know, a lot of times his players that come in are one and done. They all play offense. And he's got to put his energy into teaching them to play defense. He appreciates the defense that Ryan Howard brings for the women's team.
Minutes, but she's got three fouls already. Just 2 minutes in this game.
The biggest thing that you have to do when you're trying to get back into the game is not allow South Carolina second chance opportunities. Check out the box out by Mimi McKinney and then the second effort for the save by Ryan Howard.
So now Nene Cole will go back to the free throw line. She's 2 for 2 today. Shooting 82% from the charity stripe this afternoon.
If you want to have an opportunity to knock off the number one team in the country, you've got to get these freebies from the free throw line.
Ooh, and she'll get them both. Little home bounce. And the crowd just got turned up and silenced by Zaya Cook.
I was going to say, when Zaya Cook is on the floor, if there's anybody that's going to silence a crowd, it's number one for South Carolina.
Zaya Cook now double figures in her last 7 games. Kentucky has missed its last 11 shots from the field. Howard tries it again and gets blocked.
Howard,
and she's
Tyson.
Still down. Remember, she's got that broken left pinky. Courtney Jones, the trainer for Kentucky, will come out. Howard trying to wave her off.
Because she didn't want to come out. But the officials have had to stop play. So she's going to have to sub out at least for one play. Sure, it's her hand that was bothering her.
She's still in there.
Got Calipari on his feet.
We're taking a look to see if anything else excessive was in there. I didn't see anything extra. Yeah, as you said, I don't think that it was her hand. So they went to the monitor and didn't see anything else excessive, so it remains a block. She knew it. Did you see her turn around?
That's not the first time I've seen her do that.
The confidence exuding from Zaya Cook. Incredible. South Carolina less than a minute away from a share of the SEC regular season title. It would be their fifth.
They're talented in so many different positions, and on any night, anybody can step up big, and it has been Zaya Cook today.
Zaya Cook with 20 points. Double figures for the 21st time this season. South Carolina just continues to be tested, and they continue to pass those tests.
Absolutely. And when you're playing teams in the SEC that are familiar with you, that's what has helped Dawn Staley to build confidence in her team. She could say, look, we have seen just about everything anybody can throw at us, and they have been able to handle it and stay steady.
Cook has had 13 points in the second half, and she's 6 of 6 from the field.
And she's a freshman.
And she's crushing it. Me here with the rebound.
Look at Cook, still battling. Up 12. You love her competitive spirit.
I mean, it starts with their head coach. She pushes them on every little thing in practice every day. It shows up in games.
Well, that's why Dawn Staley has instituted more scrimmage, more competitive play in practice. It carries over into games.
Howard banks in the three. But it's not enough. South Carolina, a share of the SEC regular season title is theirs.
And it's because they can score in so many different ways. Age does not matter. They got the talent and skill and composure.
Four players in double figures for the Gamecocks, led by Zaya Cook with 20 points, and they take down Kentucky 67-58.